Hello and welcome to our concert. We are the Varsity Band, and we're delighted to be with you to showcase in our grand finale concert what we've been working on for several rehearsals. We've got a lot of fun music in store for you. This first one is called Dialogues for Winds and Percussion, and it is quite literally that. And throughout the piece, you can count the different ways that this conversation musically goes back and forth, whether it's back and forth between winds and percussion, or within winds, or within instruments. It's a lot of fun in that way. Just looking at some people, if they need seats, there's actually a lot of seats down front or towards the middle. So if we want to make room, there's that, and then there's certain spots here too. So, okay, we'll kick off the concert with Dialogues for Winds and Percussion. Thank you. not the musical merits were discussed about this next tune, more the phonetics of it. Myself calling the composer Rafe Vaughan Williams and the piece Lyndon Lee, and the kids saying, no, it's Ralph Vaughan Williams and it's Lyndon Leah. But through it, it's a really nice lyrical work that we have had a lot of success on, coming miles and miles from our first rehearsal of this piece, which was actually before the previous concert. And it was like that Cheez-It commercial where we weren't ready for it, then we put it back in the folder, check the box, not ready, come back after the next concert, not ready, and then finally for this last concert, I think you'll agree that they've come a long way in the area of phrasing and musicality. This is Lyndon Lee. Our next piece is a nice piece of poetry based on Edgar Allan Poe's The Raven, and so we've asked Kylie Nelson to share a couple of stanzas for us on this poem.
Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered, weak and weary, over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, While I nodded, nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping, as of someone gently rapping, rapping at my chamber door. "'Tis some visitor," I muttered, tapping at my chamber door. "Only this and nothing more." Open here I flung the shutter, when with many a flirt and flutter, in here stepped a stately raven of the saintly days of yore. Not the least obeisance made he, not a minute stopped or stayed he, but with mien of lord or lady, perched above my chamber door, perched upon a bust of Pallas just above my chamber door, perched and sat and nothing more. Then this ebony bird beguiling my sad fancy into smiling by the grave and stern decorum of the countenance it wore. "Though thy crest be shorn and shaven, thou," I said, "art sure no craven. Tell me what thy lordly name is on the night's Plutonian shore." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore."
very proud of this ensemble and how far they've come over the course of the year, and I hope you're encouraged by the progress of your son or daughter and of the ensemble that they're a part of. A lot of good performance happening on an everyday basis here in this varsity band. So we're going to finish with our last selection entitled Music from the Incredibles, which is one of my favorite, probably just movies in general, but soundtracks, has a really creative, poppy, jazz-like soundtrack that really drives, and it really augments our program of selections. So hopefully you enjoy our performance of The Incredibles. As we transition, the varsity band's going to come swing around this way as the freshman wind ensemble gets up and goes that way. And as we're transitioning, it would be remiss of me, go ahead and you guys can get started, to acknowledge that we actually do have, as we commemorate the seniors tonight, one senior in varsity band. We have a new member. You guys can go ahead and start coming down this way. Someone who joined our program as a senior, joined the marching band, and then due to scheduling conflicts, the band that he could fit into his schedule was sixth hour varsity band. And so at this time, I'd like to acknowledge our only senior in varsity band, and that's Ryan Engel. So Ryan has done an extraordinary job for us. And for those of you that were at our last concert, Ryan was the one that did the tom-tom solo during Electricity, that song that the lights went out.
Or at least tried.
There you go. Congrats, Ryan. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first number, actually we're going to be using the aisles on either side of the auditorium. Canzone Primi Toni 8 was actually written for St. Mark's Cathedral in Venice, and we can't perform in Venice tonight, but we'll try to make this work. So it'll take us just a moment to set up.
Thank you.
Yeah, so this was written for St. Mark's Cathedral, if you've ever had the great pleasure to be there in Venice. It's a humongous church, and there's all kinds of, it's basically the shape of a cross. And so there's all kinds of different areas of the church where you can place performers, and this composer, Giovanni Gabrielli, who was writing at the end of the 1500s and the beginning of the 1600s, used that church and its spaces to great effect and wrote many, many pieces for multiple choirs. And this is one of those pieces that's certainly stood the test of time and is beloved by chamber musicians across the globe. This is Gabrielli's Canzona Primi Toni.
Thank you.
Yeah, 397 years after that piece was composed, Tim Marr comes along and writes our next piece, which is A View from the Mountaintop. Tim Marr is a very important member of the band community in the state of Minnesota. He wrote this while he was band director at University of Minnesota Duluth in 1994, and then moved a few years after that to become director of bands at St. Olaf College, and has been there ever since, and written a number of wonderful works, this being one that I program a lot, and I really, really enjoy it. View from the Mountaintop is semi-programmatic, which means that it sort of tells a story as you listen to the piece. It depicts a great effort, and at the moment that you realize that you've achieved your goal, it's a really thrilling musical collection of sounds and rhythms. So I hope you enjoy it. This is A View from the Mountaintop by Timothy Marr. Thank you. Before we move on, I'd like to encourage you to take a moment to look at the program tonight. In addition to recognizing the seniors that are in our program and giving them a chance to tell themselves a little bit about you before their final concert, we've recognized the Letter Award winners and students who have participated in honor bands throughout the year. That's on the back cover. Please read that. To earn a varsity letter in band is really, really difficult. Lots of hours and keeping track of points and pep bands and all that kind of stuff, and everyone who's got an L by their name, and a few students in concert band that I forgot, and I'll mention the next segment of the show. We really appreciate all the efforts that they've put into this program. Our next piece by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, great master, of course, of symphonic and vocal music. This is actually from a piece that was written for orchestra and chorus, Ave Verum Corpus.
Thank you.
I got a little freaked out before that last piece. It's hard to conduct Mozart and change my head, and I forgot to say how proud I am of the students that are on stage. Varsity Band with Mr. Gullickson, I want to give you a huge congratulations for a great performance. Freshman Wind Ensemble, they've just been a joy to work with for this for the year that I've had them, and all the students that we've had lessons with. It's been a great year. I hope tonight has been a great final performance for you. Give them one last round of applause. It's going to take just a moment. We're going to bring out the concert band. We got one more great ensemble playing on this first concert this evening. Hope you can stick around for it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. We're the concert band, and our first piece is a symphonic suite from Star Trek.
Thank you.
We worked hard on this program and we made a couple of mistakes. And so I want to take a moment just to correct some of those errors. We neglected to indicate the letter award winners from Concert Band. So I'm going to read their names and have them stand and let's give them a big round of applause. To earn a letter at Eastview is very difficult in band. It takes 36 points, at least four pep bands, and that takes a fair number of hours and some dedication. And we really appreciate the work that they all put into this. So in the oboe section, Aaron Lesh is a letter award winner. In alto sax section, we have Laura Drake and Lucas Dahl. Tenor sax, Victor Mendez Robles. Barry sax, Harry Lilly. French horn, Cora Fisher. In our percussion section, Stephen Smith, Kate Gira, Sydney Diebold, and Carson Cobb are all letter winners. Let's give them a big round of applause. Also, we had a number of students in concert band to participate in solo and ensemble contest is completely voluntary, and a number of students did it, and it's such a great way to enhance your skills as a musician when it's just you and a piano player and you're carrying the whole load of that melody and that rhythm. And we had a number of students that played solos and earned superior ratings. I do want you to stand, if you would stand when I read your name. In flute section, Val Wynn and Aaron Chen. In the bass clarinet section, the whole bass clarinet section, Julia Ahern. Barry sax, Harry Lilly got a superior as well. And in our percussion section, two performers got superior ratings, Carson Cobb and Tony Lowe. Let's give them a big round of applause. And also a number of our percussionist students participated in solo and ensemble contest and got a superior for an ensemble. That's Stephen Smith, Kate Gira, Sid Diebold, Carson Cobb, Joe Kingsbury, Raj Sujanani, and Tony Lowe. Once again, let's give them a round of applause. Our next tune has been super fun to work on, just because it's so melodic and I think Caribbean Rondo, it felt right in March when we needed it really, really bad. And I definitely caught a few kids whistling these melodies in the commons after our rehearsal. And then they'd look at me and be like, "You got me," and be a little bit upset by it. But it's really fun. Hope you enjoy it too. This is Caribbean Rondo featuring three very famous Latin folk songs. Thank you. we are so thankful for the seniors that have been with us for 4 years. It's been super fun to work with them in lessons and get to know them really well. We're very fortunate teachers, and there's very few of us in the building that get to work with kids as they come in and get to work with kids as they leave. And I think that makes our job so very rewarding. And we truly are thankful for the time that families and that students put into our program and all the memories that they share with us creating music over those 4 years. It's wonderful. You can see our seniors on stage here. They're wearing the same uniform, but with a little flower to indicate their status as honored performers tonight. And our next piece is, they were a little freaked out when I said, you're all going to get a solo and you're going to stand up and play it. No, we can't do it. And it's been really, but it's been really, really fun. And I thought, you know, if you can't stand up and play a two-measure solo after 4 years, that's an implication of my teaching. So they did it. They did it. And I'm super proud. I'm proud of them anyway. But I hope you enjoy this. This is as much a gift to them and giving them a chance to honor them as hopefully it's an enjoyment for you. A wonderful piece, I'm sure you're familiar, by John Lennon. This is Imagine. Yeah, so here they are, the concert band class of 2019. It's been, they really have shown a lot of leadership in this group, in musically and in helping us be calm and practice and being good performers. And that might seem like he's just making that up. Not at all. Performance experience is a huge factor in working with a group and feeling like you can put your products on stage. And these guys have done a great job. We're really, really proud of them. We're going to take a moment here to let them come out to their families, and we given this rose as a gift to you as well. Thank you for the time and energy that you've put into our program, and hope that Eastview has been a wonderful experience for you, families as well. Certainly these kids have left their mark more than just in the band program, but created a really great legacy here at Eastview High School. We couldn't be prouder of them and more thankful to you. So we're gonna give you this moment to give them an opportunity to say thanks to you for all that you've given to them. And we'll be back with our last piece in just a moment. Thanks, seniors. And our last piece, appropriately, is River of Life.
Thank you.
On behalf of Mr. Pascarella and Mr. Gullickson and the entire administration and music faculty here, thank you so much for coming, and thank you for being a part of our program this year. Have a wonderful evening.